Brexit means Brexit.
But what does mean in Brexit means Brexit?
This is the question I set out to answer in this book. I'd spoken to so many people before and after the vote, on the Leave side and the Remain side, in Britain and on the continent, in Europe and the rest of the world, and everyone holds a different meaning in their mind, or maybe many different meanings in each of their minds. And so I thought, well, you know, meanings do matter. As much as asking why did it happen and what will happen next, what does this really mean for us, this dramatic historical moment? So I felt, well, how should we confront our different meanings and yet somehow be engaged in the same democratic conversation? For I think we really do need a common language, a kind of Hippocratic oath to export from medicine to politics, a do-no-harm Brexit of mutual respect between all the parties involved. And what could this common language be? At first, I was thinking of big notions that, from my academic reflexes, you know, we're talking about exceptionalism and skepticism and pluralism, all these big isms that we academics use. But it became clear that this is not the way we as citizens speak with one another. And I was thrown back to my childhood, listening to Greek myth from a Greek father in Paris, and thought again about the universal reach of archetypal myth, biblical or Greek. I'm not religious, but somehow I believe in these stories, which can help us somehow offer a different lens on the story of Brexit. In the first story, Brexit simply means that Britain will leave. The Brexiters are leading an exceptional people, enslaved by the shackles of Brussels, towards their promised land. Egypt, Brussels, let the people go. But what if many of the tribes that make up the British Isles resist the exodus? What if those that want to go want it for contradictory reasons? Europe is too small for us, say some. Too big for us, say the other. What if those on the continent want to turn exodus into banishment? Not your promised land, but paradise lost. There is a second story, however, that's not about Britain, but about the whole of Europe, perhaps the whole of the West. A story of reckoning, where the people say, Brexit means everyone should leave. But didn't Oedipus stab his eyes blind when he finally had to face his truth? Where does redemption lie then? Whose truth shall we heed? For whom does the bell toll? Who will pay for our mistakes and who will be saved? Do you believe in indiscriminate judgment or in the sorting out of the worthy from the sinners? Or do you believe that this last judgment will never happen, forever possible, forever postponed? Is the EU doomed or is reform possible? Skepticism simply a warning. Can we truly reimagine Europe's democratic transformation? But what if Brexit was about this moment? What if Brexit means Breshit, which in the Torah means in the beginning? What if Brexit was simply a great sacrifice on the altar of the greater good? Brexit means that Britain leaves the EU in order to save it, but perhaps not as a great heroic sacrifice, but something more ironic. Brexit demonstrates that it's precisely because you're free to leave that you shouldn't. Always look on the bright side of life. And what if we, other Europeans, were able to demonstrate that as civilized people, we do no longer believe in scapegoats and will instead ensure that Britain, Iphigenia, not only survives but thrives in her EU afterlife. And of course, that the EU does too. This project is a journey, and a journey that wouldn't exist without you. So please get involved. Please tell me what you think. Please tell me what Brexit means for you.